everything we want. And I think we should make it into a bed and breakfast. This is going to be our home.
You liked what I did?
If you want the radio station internship, it's yours.
Oh, thank you.
You're on the air.
Maybe you should think of yourself as number six.
You be number six. I want to be number one.
But nobody knows who number one is, though.
Maybe it's me.
If I don't say this right now, I swear my head is going to explode. I love you. So will you marry me?
Yes. Yes, I will.
The universe is throwing obstacles at you to see if you're really ready to get married.
Bring it on. I'm a happily engaged woman. Who's all this stuff belong to?
Sorry. David Baylor.
Sid Hansen.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Of all the ranches, colonials, and split-level dream houses, you would get the haunted one, right?
Do I have to go inside?
Only if you want to meet your new in-laws.
Owen? Owen, are you in here?
Ah, Sid, how lovely that you've come.
You said that your parents were dying to meet me.
How true. Allow me.
Nighttime already, dear brother?
Sid, may I present my sister, Annie. Annie, my fiancé, Sid.
Enchanté.
Likewise. I'm sure.
My beloved father, I give you Sid.
Ah, Sid. She looks so sweet. Ah! And my lovely ageless wife.
Ah, refreshment. It is very old. Full-bodied wine. I hope you like it.
Oh, the children of the Nile. What music they make.
What a relief, get your blood pumping. Which reminds me, dinner is served.
California. I knew they'd beat the federal government in raising those auto emission standards. Melting Arctic is going to flood the Midwest. They're going to do something to reduce the greenhouse effect, which, by the way, government has openly admitted is a true phenomenon. You look hot in that bathrobe.
I think so. You look hot in that marmalade.
Oh, thank you. That must be one of the deliveries my mother told us to look out for.
Party's not until tomorrow night.
Here's your dance floor. I need 12 by 12, 144 square feet.
Great. Well, I guess I'll rearrange the living room there.
What about the baby grand?
Baby grand?
Yeah, my mother's kind of excited. I've never been engaged before.
Wait. Yeah, move that. Right behind the couch.
Got it.
Hey. Hey! Owen, that guy just took a picture of me. Who did your mother send to deliver the piano?
photojournalist?
Yeah, I told you my parents had a unique way of doing things, so let me call him. Yeah, penthouse suite, please. Name's Jones. Yeah, mother, yes, it's Owen. No caterer, but the piano and the dance floor are here. No, no, Sid doesn't go into work till about 11. Oh, great. Yeah, we'll see you then. Good. What?
I'm not supposed to meet them till tomorrow. Everything's planned for tomorrow.
Ah, come on, don't worry. They are gonna love you.
I'm not worried. Parents always love me.
Okay, good.
If I take another 500 out of landscaping, we're gonna squeeze by on the money our parents invested.
We'll decorate the guest rooms first so we can generate income as soon as possible. You guys are really doing this B&B thing, huh?
Yeah, we're hoping to be in by February.
That's ambitious. Mm-hmm. Holy Martha Stewart. Mm-hmm. Do you make this?
I have a million ideas. It's a Victorian house, but I don't want it too Victorian. No floral wallpaper, no themes. Well, I gotta run.
Where are you going?
I have an appointment with a designer.
You didn't say anything about a designer. Designer's not in the budget.
Oh, it's just a consultation.
Honey, I could watch him.
I want to take him with me.
Okay, bye.
Bye. You do realize you're married to Superwoman, right?
What is going on down there?
Beats me.
They're expecting another delivery tomorrow.
It's the third time this week, right?
Right. It's time to execute the plan.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Hey, Dad. What's going on?
Nothing.
What's going on with you?
Okay, then.
10 seconds to go.
Owen. They might be a little late. It's impossible to always be exactly on time.
3, 2, 1. That's their knock. Come on. Mother.
Mon petit prince. You're even handsomer than I remember. Oh, darling.
Son, great to see you.
Mother, Dad, this is Sid.
Hi, I'm Sid.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
So how's your hotel?
Well, it's lovely, perfectly lovely. Oh, good, good. You know, I thought it was so funny, ironic funny, that you could use an alias at the Westin. I always thought that your name had to match your credit card. You'd probably have a fake ID or something. You know what you're doing? Please, come in.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Can I get you something to drink?
Well, that sounds delightful. I'll take a cup of cocoa, dear.
We don't have cocoa. We have water.
Birch beer in the crisper?
Water, please, and no ice, if you don't mind.
Oh, I don't mind at all.
Have you heard from Annie? She canceled the reservation your mother made for her, and she refused to fly with her.
Well, you can't blame her after the Zurich incident.
Mm-hmm.
What was the Zurich incident?
A family matter.
Sid is family, Mother.
Of course.
Annie emailed last night, said she's going to be in tomorrow by 6.
Oh, good.
Good. This is cute.
That's my favorite mug. Get it? Mug.
The floor looks great. We'll waltz up a storm, won't we, Sid?
You're asking the wrong person. Sid hates to waltz.
I don't hate to waltz.
That's okay. Everybody's got something they hate to do. If you hate waltzing, just tell us.
You know, I really don't want to be late for work, so it was wonderful meeting both of you, and I'll see you tomorrow night at the party.
Okay.
Okay? Bye-bye.
What a charming girl.
Thanks for seeing him on such short notice.
Ah, no worries. Ah, 2 more pounds in last month. You have absolutely nothing to worry about, Tina. He's thriving.
But I'm not producing enough milk.
And why do you think that?
Because he always wants more, and I can't satisfy him. I wanted to breastfeed for at least a year.
Well, he's probably going through a growth spurt, and that's why he wants to nurse all the time. What about you? You look exhausted.
I can't sleep. My mind just, it won't shut off. First, I thought it was the baby. But...
Look, the most important thing you can do for Nicholas is to take care of yourself. Have Robbie take him a few hours every now and again so that you can rest. It'll be good for everyone.
is Jazzy Joanie inside an 80s flashback. That was The Cure's Just Like Heaven, the best love song ever. If you're caller number 6, you got yourself a free WWEN baseball hat. This is Jazzy Joanie.
Yo, Jazzy Joe, am I number 6?
Not even close. You're on the air with Jazzy Joanie.
Am I number 6?
You got yourself a new baseball hat, number 6. Any thoughts on the song?
Yeah, it's not really a love song. Not in the traditional sense. She's a dream. A fantasy. They've never met.
Where's your film noir section?
Aisle 2. Sorry, number 1, but customer always comes first. Be seeing you, number 1.
I brought you some froyo.
He works in a video store.
Who?
Number 6.
What are you doing?
Narrowing it down. Okay. Here is our measly 8-mile broadcast radius and only 4 video stores fall within it. One of them is number 6's.
Are you gonna tell them who you are?
And subject myself to the shortcomings of reality? No way. I'll disguise my voice. Yeah.
I'll get the scope.
What do we got?
Approximately 25-year-old Jane Doe. Failure to fly, about 50 feet. Hit the windshield of patient number 2's moving motor vehicle. Multiple lacerations front and back. Evacuated in the field after no spontaneous respirations. Mayfield Flutter BP is 150 over 85.
Please don't let her die.
What's this?
Luke English, 28 years old, vital state. Had a chest compression from contusions on his sternum with cerebral impact. Seatbelt was on. No complaint of abdominal tenderness.
Okay. All right, Luke, she's in very good hands. Okay, we just need you to relax.
3, 2, 1.
Do that faster.
Got it. Hold up.
Hyperventilator. Relieve cerebral pressure.
I want to know how she fell off an overpass.
That's not our problem right now.
She's got a skull fracture, blood in her ears. Pupils are unequal. One's blown, one's sluggish.
For radiology, someone got a massive head trauma for a stat CT.
Got it.
Look at these scars.
We are doing everything we can to keep her alive.
I'm just saying, if you can't, that's probably the way she would have wanted it.
Thank you, Jose. We'll take it from here.
We're ready to take her to CT.
Okay, she's bradycardic and heart rate's irregular.
She's in a systole.
All right, Izzy, we need 1 milligram atropine, 1 milligram epi IV push.
Is it morning already?
What happened to you yesterday? You're acting a little cuckoo.
I was so nervous. Do your parents hate me?
No, they don't. They just have super high standards. Didn't mean it like that.
Why did you tell them I hated to waltz?
Because when I asked you to waltz at the Congo Room, you said that waltzing was for old farts.
Well, it is. But I had just met them. What was with your mom stealing the mug?
I'm sure it was nothing. Why are you making such a big deal about this?
Because I'm exhausted. And I love you, and I want your parents to like me.
I told you they're gonna love you, and we're gonna have a great time at this party tonight.
You're right. You're right. I just wish I was going on more than 4 hours sleep.
Hey, Dad.
Rob, hi.
What, are you working for Buffy the Vampire Slayer?
It's not what it looks like.
What does it look like?
I'll see you at Sid's party.
Wait a minute, I thought we were riding together.
Oh, yeah, no. I'll meet you there. I've got to set up something important. So, if I'm a couple minutes late, could you...
Cover for you. No, I'm not getting involved in... I don't know what, not unless you tell me where you're going.
Out?
Fine. I'll let everyone know.
Thanks, Ron.
Hello.
Can I help you?
Got any episodes of The Prisoner? Or take episode 3?
Oh, I'm afraid we don't carry subversive material. Our rated R and PG films are adolescent proof.
Adolescent proof?
Edited for inappropriate contents of the rated G.
Right.
There's only one store in town seditious enough to... One moment.
Right. Toodaloo.
Hey.
Hey.
Any news on that girl?
She's critical, but stable.
Still a Jane Doe?
Yeah, nobody's ID'd her yet.
And the guy she came in with, Luke, been up all night.
Oh, it looks like you were with him.
Says he saw her falling in slow motion. He says it was a fate, the way he met her.
She was trying to commit suicide.
I'm not saying he could have saved her. There just has to be a reason that she hit his car.
Is there something else going on here?
It's gonna take me forever to strip this house by myself. Especially if my wife using is a painter's palette. Okay, fine, but if I don't see you by then, Victor, I'm gonna have to go with another house painter. All right.
Can't just go with another house painter. Victor's estimate was the only one remotely within our budget.
Don't worry, honey, that was just an idle threat.
Part of a greater strategy.
Did you use the greater strategy with the carpenter that was supposed to be here 2 days ago? None of these are working.
Well, they're every shade of yellow the store had.
Well, then I'll just have to try another store.
Honey, come on. You can't carry the baby, the pain, and whatever else you're planning on buying.
I'll manage.
Okay, well, then I'm going with you. You can't do everything alone.
Psst. What? Isn't that your fiancé with that gorgeous redhead?
Sid, I would like you to meet my little sister, Annie.
Sid, hi. It is great to meet you.
Oh, you too.
Hey, have you seen the stash of... Oh, I'm sorry. Am I interrupting?
No, David, this is my fiancé, Owen. Owen, this is David Baylor.
The lawyer?
The guy who lives in the lounge.
And this is Owen's sister, Annie. Hi.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
Annie's flight got in early, so we were hoping you could join us for lunch.
Oh, I wish I could, but...
Go ahead. Go on, you can take my lunch break, too. It's okay. Go.
Go.
It's okay. Go.
Come on.
Come on.
All right.
Let's go. Come on.
Hello. Don't suppose you blokes got episode 3 of The Prisoner?
I got a copy in the back.
Hey, could you throw me episode 3 of The Prisoner? There's this freaky chick out there asking for it.
Freaky good or freaky bad?
I don't know. Freaky.
You're freaky.
She's hot. Not when she opens her mouth. She's got this crazy English accent.
She's English?
Or Australian. I don't know. She talks like a parrot.
You were the one that didn't let the foundation sit long enough. The first floor sank 2 inches in 6 months.
Design flaw.
You wish. Frank Lloyd Wright would have envied my blueprints.
Wow. So you designed your own house.
Yeah, it's a rite of passage. Our parents gave us a piece of land once we both turned 16 and let us build whatever we wanted. You guys should do the same thing with your kids.
Great idea.
I just wish we could have lived there longer than 2 months.
By the time I was 16, we'd lived in 8 cities in 5 different countries.
With a bizarre cast of characters streaming in and out of our lives.
Do you remember when that guy with the green glasses gave Mother the Spanish Arabian Stallion?
Wearing the emerald necklace? God, what a freak.
Have a mate here, sky stuff.
Vinya Yadot sky zirks.
So you speak Swedish?
It's Latvian.
Wow. Yeah, Owen was telling me that your parents were consultants.
It sounds a little more mysterious than that. What, are they spies or something? My tuvinia Katesy?
Can you put it to his Thomas? I am sorry. We are really being rude. It's just that...
We didn't mean to exclude you. It's just we haven't seen each other in so long.
Cheers.
Cheers. Be hungry since I took your lunch break.
Why, thank you. So how was it, my lunch break?
I thought I was an overachiever until I met the Frank family.
Hey, what's his little sister do?
She's a rocket scientist, literally. I mean, she has spent the last 6 months working on the new space shuttle. They speak Latvian. I had no idea that Owen spoke Latvian, and I just... I'm sorry. I don't mean to babble on like this.
No, it's okay. I got to eat sometime.
Dr. Hansen, Dr. Baylor, they need you in ICU. You're Jane Doe coded again.
Seconds.
Here I come.
3, 2, 1.
Hello.
Hey. Hello. Would you like some hot cocoa?
At this hour? No, I'll take a gin and tonic.
Bar's in the kitchen, Dan.
Okay. Sorry, I'm late. I said you look beautiful.
Oh, you do too.
You gonna have time to make Sid's wedding dress?
I better, because that's our engagement gift. There you go. Here's your hat, baby. Thought you were going to wrap it, hon.
You better get dressed, because we're already supposed to be there.
Well, my clothes are hanging in the bathroom. I'll just be a second. Yeah.
Hey. Nicholas Hansen climbed up a tree with me and a monkey named Allie. And then when a bumblebee flew by, we climbed mo high.
No!
Honey, are you okay?
Pulled a button off my shirt. It's the only thing that I have to wear that isn't wrinkled, and I've been planning on wearing it all week.
Sweetie, don't worry about it. You could wear a potato sack and look beautiful.
No, I couldn't. And it's Sid's engagement party. Your sister always has everything sewed together, you know? And what are Owen's parents gonna think of me? Everyone's gonna laugh. And I'm not gonna know what to do.
Honey, are you okay? Because I'm starting to worry about you.
No, you don't have to worry about me.
Are you guys ready? We're late.
Yeah, it's just gonna just be another minute.
Then I decided to stay in Los Angeles and have a go of it.
Oh, is that when you were registered as a Republican?
You're a Republican?
For about 30 seconds. How did you know that?
Yeah, how did you know that?
I'm sure you mentioned it.
How could I have mentioned it if I didn't know it?
I'll get that.
Oh, God. Am I glad to see you guys.
Sorry we're late.
Okay, here's the Claudia Schiffer.
Annie, Owen's sister.
Joanie?
Annie?
I love your dress.
Okay, that necklace? Gorgeous.
Hi.
Oh. Hey, I'm Robbie.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. This is my wife, Tina.
Nice to meet you.
And our son, Nicholas.
Oh, he's so cute.
Where's Dad?
Oh, Dad, he might be a little late. Yeah.
He's already a little late. Where is he?
Out.
God, sounds like your dad's almost as mysterious as ours.
Glad to see you understand.
Come on in. Can I get you something to drink? Oh,
you like this view. Gorgeous. You're doing great.
Mm. I propose a love game for the occasion. A compatibility questionnaire for the special couple.
Remind me to breathe.
Number one, you're walking in the woods. Who are you with? This represents the most important person in your life. Mm. Owen wrote, Sid. Sid wrote, I'm by myself.
Well, I always liked an independent woman.
You can't love another until you love yourself.
You encounter an animal, what type of animal is it? The size of the animal represents how you view the size of your problems. Owen wrote, spider. Sid wrote, dinosaur.
They're extinct. Get it? It's a joke.
Describe your reaction to the animal. This shows how you deal with your problems. Owen wrote, I study it. Sid wrote, I run away from it as fast as I can.
Dinner served.
Okay.
There are only two questions left.
I'm starving.
So am I. Son, don't pay attention to her profiling tools. Although I found your answers oddly divergent. Neither you nor Sid can be reduced to five silly questions.
Thanks, Dad.
Where did you say your father was?
The meeting.
Of the highest proportions. Hmm. I'm sure he'll be here soon.
So, you guys have a date yet?
Yeah, well, we were thinking that... go ahead.
Well, Owen thought Christmas would be nice.
But Sid's always wanted a June wedding.
I agree with Sid. A June wedding gives us much more time to plan.
Nora, Juganzi Moe Kwanzi.
Wabu Chue Ding.
Haba Oye Ye.
You speak Japanese, too?
It's Chinese.
Rate esse ose. Okay.
Doubt they speak any pig Latin, Joanie.
I'm sorry. Pig Latin? Well, what a fascinating sound.
Will you teach us, darling?
I udwe ibe honored, hey?
Oh, very sweet.
1,400 hours at the hotel downtown. I want the entire committee assembled.
Hey, 007. That's what the tricked out watch.
Excuse me?
Your watch. I saw you talking into it. What is it, some kind of tape recorder, phone, what?
Huh, sounds like it's time to dance.
You okay?
Just taking a breather. I'll be down in a few minutes.
Okay.
What's your problem?
They're great. You're not getting the vibe that I'm not good enough for them.
What are you talking about? I'm a single mom in a community college, and they love me. Where's Dad?
Robbie, the man I'm looking for. Excuse us, Charles. One, two, three.
Sid, may I have this dance?
Oh, well, thank you. How about the next one? All right.
Joanie?
Like Ginger Rogers.
This is the engagement party. Can you imagine what the wedding will be like?
I hope you have a fire escape, because if not, Sid just jumped out the window.
I'll be right back. You okay?
No, actually, you're gonna think I'm a little crazy. But there's this guy who's been following me around, and he just showed up at our apartment and gave your mother a gun case.
A gun case?
First of all, the delivery guy takes my picture, and then your mother steals the mug with my face on it. Your parents are in town under fictitious names, and my brother heard your father making a phone call into his watch, and poof, out of nowhere, this guy who's been stalking me shows up at our party. Would you please tell me what's going on?
I don't think we should be having this conversation right now.
Why didn't you tell me more about your family?
I wasn't hiding anything. To me, they're normal.
Well, I feel like your mother is judging every word I say.
Forget about her. I love you, Sid. I'm here for you. Nothing is ever going to change that.
Well, then show me. I need to feel like you're on my side.
I admit they're being a little tough on you.
Tough on me? They hate me, and frankly, I'm not sure how much I like them either. Second.
I wondered if we could have a chat.
Sure.
The man with the beard didn't deliver a gun case. He's an artist whom I employed to make this. I have one of Charles, myself, and both the kids. And since you're a part of the family now, I wanted one of you too. The picture they piano delivery man took was blurry, and the photo on your mug was too small to paint from, so the artist was kind enough to go to the hospital and study you himself.
This was all so confusing. I'm so sorry for what I said.
Well, it's completely understandable given the circumstances. I'm sorry that I upset you. It's not easy letting go. But it's clear that you and Owen love each other very much. I've never seen him so happy. And I'm happy for both of you. Welcome to the family, Sid.
Thank you. Can I ask you a question? What do you and your husband really do?
Can you keep a secret?
Look, your father's on TV.
Activists blocked the entrance of Lip Free Cosmetics to prevent the delivery of animals intended for product testing. But the protest came to a screeching halt when authorities were informed of the rebellious behavior by a company employee who spoke under the condition of anonymity. Lip Free Cosmetics refused to comment on their use of animals for product testing, primarily mascara, eyeshadow, and lipstick. Among the animals reportedly saved were bunnies, monkeys, and kittens.
Come on, easy!
Dad.
Oh, Dad. Nora and Charles Frank, Owen's parents, and Annie, Owen's sister. This is my father, Jim Hansen.
Hi, all.
Well, a pleasure.
How do you do? Nice to meet you.
Well, that's some pretty subversive behavior, Jim. We're impressed.
Jim Hansen, you're free on bail.
Can't believe I'm picking you up from the big house, and now you got a record, too.
I'll make a call, make this go away.
Really?
She's joking. Now, let's celebrate your father as a hero tonight. Don?
Really wish you could have thought of me first this time, Dad.
Sid,
I needed you. I needed you there with me.
Come on, Jim. I'm proud of you.
Sure generates a lot of laundry for such a little guy.
Yeah, well, it only gets worse.
doing?
Baby, you've been up since 5:30.
I'll finish the laundry. I'll watch Nick. Why don't you take a little nap?
I'm not tired.
You seem a little tired.
What are you trying to say?
I just want to do something nice for you. What if I promise to wake you up in an hour?
If number six calls in right now, he wins a trip for two to
Miami.
Forget Miami, you're going to Bora Bora. You're on the air with Jesse Joanie.
Looks like I'm going to Bora Bora.
It's for two, you know.
So maybe I'll go twice.
And it's not really a trip. In the traditional sense, it's a fantasy. Pure potential.
Unscathed by the shortcomings of reality? Yeah. Sounds like heaven to me. Be seeing you, number one.
Be seeing you, number six.
Are you feeling all right? I thought this was a punk rock set.
I'm gonna tell him who I am. Without the stupid accent. Wait, right now? You can't leave! I don't know how to do this. But I knew something. I don't know nothing, but
I got a feeling. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Sid. I never got a chance to give you your engagement gift. May I come in?
Sure.
I'm so sorry about last night, Sid. The situation spiraled out of control. I tried to stop it, and I'm sorry that got in the way of my being at your party. Because you're right. I should have been there. Please, open it. Your mother intended for you to have this on your wedding day. I figure she wouldn't mind if it came a little early.
This one has my name on it.
I gave that to her the day you were born. And I gave her this one on the day we were married. I said your mother would have loved to have been at your party. Well, we both would have. Can you forgive me? Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. I'm so sorry.
Pizza for Tina. No, 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 forget about it. The guy already included the tip. Have a good one.
Dropped charges against animal activists who chained themselves to the company's research laboratory to prevent the delivery of product testing animals. The action comes as a surprise to law experts following the case, who call this decision utterly baffling.
Excuse me. I'm looking for another guy that works here. He's in his 20s, blonde hair, blue eyes.
He's not working this afternoon.
But I just talked to him on... It's you, isn't it?
Disappointed?
Definitely. I mean, who in their right mind believes a ball named Rover can keep people trapped on an island? I believe this belongs to you.
Oh, right. Thank you very much.
Okay. I should probably get back. I run the Barkery on Bentley Avenue if you ever want to stop by for some coffee.
Looks like the mystery's over. Jazzy Joanie.
You kidding? Mystery's just begun. Leo.
Be seeing you, number six.
Joanie, get back in here.
I really have to go.
Okay.
Bye.
So hard. Just follow my lead.
Turning back on his best friend, if he put her down.